I am Dr. Patil Sunilkumar S, Professor and Head Civil Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today, let us discuss on numerical example on design of multi-span RCC continuous beam. Learning outcomes. At the end of this session, the viewers will be able to design a multi-span RCC continuous beam. This is an example. Design a continuous rectangular beam of span 7 meter each to carry a dead load of 12 kN per meter and a live load of 16 kN per meter. The beam is continuous over a more than 3 spans and is supported by columns. Use M20 concrete and Fe415 steel. So it is given span 7 meter, WD 12 kN per meter, WL that is live load 16 kN per meter, FCK that is characteristic strength 20 Newton per m square, and yield strength FY is 415 Newton per m square. First step. So we have to assume the cross sectional dimensions of the beam based on the serviceability criteria, that is span to depth ratio. So effect to depth is taken usually 1/15th to 1/20th of the span. Span is here 7000 mm. So therefore, D will be 450 mm. Let us consider D equal to effective depth equal to 450 mm. The overall depth will be equal to, let us say, 500 mm by considering 50 mm effective cover. So assume breadth as 250 mm. Design moment mu and design shear force vu are to be determined. So for this we have to calculate the dead load, because now we have chosen the section, so therefore we have to calculate the dead load, which consists of self weight of the beam based on the cross section chosen, then dead load from slab and dead load from floor finish. So self weight of the beam, it is 0.25 into 0.5 into 25. 25 is density of concrete, 25 kN per cubic meter. So therefore, this is 3.125 kN per meter. So dead load from slab is 12 kN per meter. Floor finish load, we have assumed 0.875 kN per meter. So total dead load is 16 kN per meter. So the live load is already given. It is 16 kN per meter. So W, we are supposed to find out design loads. So design load is the partial safety factor into dead load, that is 1.5 into 16, and this is again 1.5 into 16, that is the live load. So these are design loads. So one has to refer the IS 456-2000 table number 12 for bending moment coefficients and table number 13 for shear force coefficients. So this is table number 12 and this is table number 13 for the shear force coefficients. So here we get the first dead load, and for live load the coefficients are given for different conditions. These are span moments, and here we get support moments. So again, span moment at two sections, so near middle of the end span and at the middle of the interest span. Again, for the span moments we are having at the span next to end support, and at the support next to end support, and at interior supports. So now, can you guess what are the coefficient, bending moment coefficients as per the table number 12 of IS 456-2000 for dead load and imposed load to get a highest span moment? And this is a question for highest shear force, that is dead load and the imposed load coefficients to get a maximum shear force. Can you guess, please? So this is the answer. So for bending moment coefficient, it is the minus 1 by 10 for WD and minus 1 by 9 for WL. And for shear, it is 0.6 for dead load and 0.6 for live load. Now the moment is maximum at the support next to end support. The design moment is 1.5 times the maximum bending moment. Therefore, we have multiplied by 1.5 everywhere. So mu support moment and the moment at midspan. So we are having two types of moment. This is support moment is hogging and midspan moment is sagging. Now the shear force is maximum at the support next to end support, that is on the outer side. The design shear is 1.5 times the maximum shear force. Again, it is multiplied by 1.5 into 16 into 0.6 into 7. So we get 201.6 kilonewton. Now the next is we are step 3, that is design of longitudinal reinforcement. Since IS456 Fe415 is used, steel is used, axial limit is equal to 0.48d as per IS. So we get 216, MU limit is given by 0.36 FCKB into axial limit into D minus 0.42 axial limit. So this is G.1.1C. So accordingly we are getting 139.688 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm. So MU is greater than MU limit. So hence a doubly reinforced section is to be designed. So using equilibrium equation of a singly reinforced section, find first the steel for the singly reinforced section, that is EST1. So this is the equation 0.87 FY EST into D minus 0.42 XU limit is equal to the, this is your MU limit which we have calculated for singly reinforced section. We get EST1 is equal to 1077 mm square. Now equating the moment of resistance offered by force in compression steel and additional steel AST2, we get, that is the force offered by AST2, for this is required for equilibrium. So therefore 0.87 FY AST2 into D minus D dash, this is lever arm, is equal to MU minus MU limit. This is balance moment. So we get AST2 is equal to 752 mm square. So AST2, so total steel to be provided AST is AST1 plus AST2. Then since strain varies linearly, we get this equation, that is epsilon SC is equal to 216 minus 50 divided by 216 into 0.0035. This is 0.0035 is maximum strain at the extreme fiber. So we get the strain. Then by referring IS456 figure number 23, we can find out what is the stress in compression steel. So it works out to be 0.83 FY. So equating compression force in steel to tensile force in additional steel which we are providing, we get FSC into ASC is equal to 0.87 FY into AST2. So from this we can find out ASC, that is the compression steel, it is 788 mm square. Provide 6 bars of 20 mm bars in tensile zone and 3 20 mm bars in compression zone. So that is which will be sufficient to have the area will be more than this. At midspan, again MU is different, this is sagging moment. So MU again at midspan is also greater than MU limit. So therefore AST1 is the same we have done for the support, we get AST1 is equal to 1077 mm square and AST2 here it is 525 mm square because here moment is little less than the support moment. So next FSC again determined from figure 23 of IS456, we get ASC is equal to 550 mm square and AST, that is at bottom, here it is sagging, therefore AST is the tensile steel at bottom, it is 15, AST1 plus AST2, it is 1502 mm square. So provide 6 bars of 20 mm diameter in tension zone and 2 bars of 20 mm diameter in the compression zone. Now for shear reinforcement, so VU is equal to, we have already calculated maximum shear force, that is 201.6 kilonewton. So tau V, that is nominal shear stress, is equal to VU upon BD, it is 1.792 newton per mm square. So we have to calculate percentage steel to find out tau C, that is the shear strength of concrete from table 19 of IS456. So percentage steel is 1.676. And by referring table 19, we can get what is strength of concrete. So shear strength that can be taken by concrete, tau C, it is 0.74 newton per mm square. So VUS is balance shear force, which is to be taken by the stirrups. It is VU minus tau CBD. So we have to calculate VUS. And as per clause number 40.4.4a of IS456, we get VUS is equal to 0.87 FYASV into D divided by SV. From this we can find out SV is the spacing of stirrups, ASV is the area of stirrup. So since two-legged is used, 8 mm two-legged 8 mm stirrups are used, here it is 2 into area of pi by 4 into 8 square. So we will find out what is the spacing, it is 137.2 mm. So provide two-legged stirrups at 130 mm center to center. Now check for deflection. So we have to calculate L by D max. So basic value as per IS 456 clause number 23.2.1A, and it is 26 for continuous. So IS from figure 4 of IS 456 for PT is equal to, that is percentage steel is equal to 1.676, we will get modification factor F1 is equal to 0.9. So FS, so modification factor is determined from figure 4. So FS we have to calculate for that, then percentage steel is this much. So from, since we are having a compression steel, we have to refer figure number 5 for finding the modification factor F2, that works out to be 1.23. So from figure number 6, so because it is again a T beam here, for the mid span we will be designing it as T beam, therefore F3 again we get. So if you consider it as rectangle beam, then it is 1. If you consider it as T beam, then it will give you some value. So therefore we have to complete the L by D max. So L by D max work out to be 15.55. So L by D provided is 15.55, which is less than L by D max, it is 28.78. Hence deflection control is satisfactory. Now this is the reinforcement details of continuous beam. Here you will find the steel is maximum at bottom here, and here it is at top. So over the support we get maximum steel. So because we are having end moment, that is, this is only one span we have shown here, only one span we have shown out of three spans. So for the center we get 6 bars at bottom, and at the end we have 6 bars at top. So therefore this is the section at mid span, and this is the section at support. So these are the references which we have used for this particular presentation. Thank you one and all.